Following an harrowing incident in which a police constable Ivan Wawire shot dead, businessman of Indian origin Uttam Bhandari at Raja Chambers along Parliamentary Avenue in Kampala on Friday. Police have disclosed that the suspected killer was disarmed 6 years ago due to his medical conditions, and his current deployment was at CCTV monitoring center.
The suspect's medical conditions. Police management at CPS had taken the decision about 5 years ago not to arm the suspect with a gun. He has been, and they took a decision that she should be deployed in places where he will not require a gun to do his work.
The Kampala Metropolitan Police spokesperson Patrick Onyango disclosed to journalists today that Wawire stole the gun of his housemate, PC Stephen Mulambo, which he used to end the life of the Indian moneylender. The owner of the gun has already been arrested and detained at Chireka, according to Onyango.
To limited accommodation within the force, he was sharing a house with a fellow police officer. So on the 12th of May 2023, his housemate had worked at night. He did not return the gun to the armorer. Instead, went with it to their house, and shortly he got a call that one of his child is sick. So he went to check on the child, leaving behind the gun. The suspect took the advantage that since I've spent over 6 years without touching a gun, this is the opportunity that has come. So he got the gun and went and misused it.
Police have hastened the search of the errant policeman, who is still at large. He was nearly arrested on Friday evening while on board of Global Bus en route to Rukunjiri, where he has a wife. But Wawire disembarked from Mpiji before they could nab him, and has since disappeared. Police believes the CCTV footage, which has been retrieved from Raja Chambers, is enough evidence to facilitate the full trial of Wawire. Dennis Nyangweso, the Samia Bugwe Central legislator, says Wawire is a born of his constituency, and his father, Mzee Ojambo, has informed him that he has been battling mental health challenges and receiving treatment.
Actually, coincidentally, we share even a sub-county. It should one of my voters. So I immediately reached out to the family and asked the father what could have happened. And the father had some interesting historical information that his son had been treated of psychiatry in Botabika for some time. This is information I'm yet to verify, and was discharged.
Meanwhile, Ali Malay, a counseling psychologist from A to Z Professional Counselors and Support Center, has advised security agencies to consider periodical psychosocial assessments of policemen and army men in order to mitigate the gun violence on the rampage.
I would like to appeal, first of all, to the commanders of the security deployments, security guards, security personnel, and all the officers in the highest rank, to think about psychosocial assessment of the officers at least once in a month, to check out, to do the checks and balances on those who are affected with stress, trauma, depression.
President Yoweri Museveni has also come out through his Twitter handle to condemn the killing of the Indian businessman and condoles with the mourning Indian community. Museveni poses 6 questions to police, including how an off-duty policeman accessed a gun, how he walked away from his guard post without permission with a gun to commit crime. The president also questions why the police didn't act appropriately if Wawire had a history of mental instability. Meanwhile, another person has been found dead near Parliament, just a few meters from the Friday crime scene. Vincent Okot, a security guard at a neighboring facility, says the body is of a stranger who showed up on the area alive yesterday evening.
I there for the whole night. In the night, the man started screaming, the man lay there, and now in the morning we are going to find the man is still lying there up to morning. for the whole night.
The body was lying near the back entrance of the Ministry of Constitutional Affairs in Kampala and has since been removed by police and taken to City Mortuary for post-mortem. This story was filed by Fred Kajubi for the news.